As the parade of graduates approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today. Delaware, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Georgia, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Maryland, South Carolina, New Hampshire, Virginia, New York, North Carolina, Rhode Island, Vermont, Kentucky, Tennessee, Ohio, Louisiana, Indiana, Mississippi, Illinois, Alabama, Maine, Missouri, Arkansas, Michigan, Florida, Texas, Iowa, Wisconsin, California, Minnesota, Oregon, Kansas, West Virginia, Nevada, Nebraska, Colorado, North Dakota, South Dakota, Montana, Washington, Idaho, Wyoming, Utah, Oklahoma, New Mexico, Arizona, Alaska, Hawaii, District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, Guam, American Samoa, Northern Mariana Islands, U.S. Virgin Islands. Flags. Order. Arms. And now, we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Drill Hall and are announced in the following order. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we welcome today's graduating division. Thank you.
at today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders, follow up and collect our remarks.
Divisions. Counter. March. Thank you.
For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand. And we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant Daniel Aquino, Crew Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I'd like to welcome you to today's pass interview. Today, you'll see the 6 divisions comprised of 470 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon to join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position that's in your deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Trenton McGuire from Mount Gilead, North Carolina. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the state flagship on their 6th week of training, the staff unit on their 7th week of training, and the triple threat unit on their 10th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During the night of arrival, recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and our crew chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they'll raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each crew chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from there, right. Division 04. 5. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Maurice Marsh. Chief Petty Officer Philip Brown. Petty Officer First Class Jason Moore. And their Crew Chief Petty Officer Seaman Devante Braxton from Oxon Hill, Maryland. Division 046. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Dwayne Thompson. Petty Officer First Class Anthony Ballot. Petty Officer First Class Wesley Green. And their Crew Chief Petty Officer Seaman Spencer Haley from Melbourne, Australia. Division 047. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Marlon Best. Petty Officer First Class Marisol Martinez. Petty Officer First Class Nashira Washington. And their Crew Chief Petty Officer Seaman Apprentice Jeree Smith from Roxboro, North Carolina. Division 049. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Daniel Ortega. Petty Officer First Class Enrico Colantes. Petty Officer First Class Anthony Spence. And their Crew Chief Petty Officer Seaman Recruit Chris Arnold from Chula Vista, California. Division 050. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Nicholas Brandt. Petty Officer First Class, Lucas Millantini. Petty Officer Second Class, Destiny Becker. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Apprentice, Brandon Veely, from Olympia, Washington. Division 910. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Christopher Clemenson. Petty Officer First Class Zachary Dancy. Petty Officer First Class Winston Winslet. And their Crew Chief Petty Officer Seaman Rachel Duff from Hamilton, Ohio. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job. Well done. In a moment, we'll see the ceremonial side boards, Boatswain and Honor Guard take their places for arrival honors. This time our tradition is our formal greeting for this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for rival honors, marching honor of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony, letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arrive.
Captain, United States Navy, arriving. The guests may be seated.
Yes, please rise. Present art.
Order. Art. Jacqueline Torres will offer this morning's invocation.
Before I invite you to pray with me, I'd like to say how proud I am of each and every one of you, especially my son, Seaman Recruit Benjamin Torres, who, yes, it may. Let us pray. Holy God, as we gather here today in the shadows of greatness, we welcome you with hearts full of gratitude and reverence. We stand at the threshold of this momentous occasion, the culmination of weeks of dedication, sacrifice, and unwavering commitment. As these sailors prepare to embark on their journey, we lift our voices in prayer, seeking your guidance and protection over each and every one of them. We give thanks for the strength and resilience instilled in these brave men and women who have endured the rigors of boot camp with courage and determination. Through many trials and triumphs, they have emerged as warriors, anchored in the great traditions of those who have gone before them. Bless each sailor, O Lord, with wisdom and discernment as they now have the watch. Grant them clarity of mind and a deep sense of purpose, that they may serve with distinction, navigating the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. Watch over their families as well, who have stood by their side with unwavering support and love. Strengthen the bonds that unite them, even in times of separation, and grant them peace, knowing that you are ever present, guiding and protecting those whom you love. As we celebrate this momentous occasion, we humbly ask for your blessings upon Recruit Training Command and all who pass through its gates. May it be a beacon of hope and a fortress of strength, shaping future generations of sailors who will honorably serve our country. In your most holy name, I pray. Amen.
All prisoners accounted for, ma'am! Reservoir Com 4, sir.
Very well. The Sailor's Creed!
Sound up!
I am absolutely one of the energy I have this morning. It's hilarious because this is your moment, and we couldn't be prouder to be part of this reunion of sorts. And so, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Captain Ken Frober, Commanding Officer of Recruit Training Command. Welcome, family and friends, to your quarterdeck in the United States Navy. And those watching live from around the world, we hope you're enjoying it, because there's more to come. Joining us today as our reviewing officer is Captain Matt Arnold, United States Navy. I would also like to acknowledge the staff from our fleet sponsor, Naval Education, Training, Security, Assistance, and Field Activities, sponsoring Division 049. Our fleet sponsor program allows recruits to connect with sailors from the Navy commands from around the world for valuable mentoring and motivation while here at Recruit Training Command. I would also like to welcome all our veterans in the audience today, and those watching live from around the world. Will all our veterans please stand so we give you a round of applause. Thank you for your service to our country. Division 910 graduates today, and that's where I'm getting a lot of that energy from, so let's give them a round of applause. It's a triple threat unit that represents our choir, our drill team, and our band, and they are outstanding, just like these other sailors standing in front of you right now. Five additional divisions are joining that division on this deck today, representing the sailors that will go out to our fleet. Staff and Recruit Training Command is committed to providing the United States Navy basically trained, physically fit, smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing before you here today. These sailors have completed 10 rigorous weeks of demanding recruit training and earned the right to wear the uniform recognized around the world as a symbol of freedom. I would also like to take a moment to introduce you, your family and friends, to your new Navy family. As you reconnect with your sailors shortly and navigate your new journey together, I invite you to learn more about your Navy family opportunities here at Great Lakes and around the world. Search Navy Boot Camp, Navy Family to learn more about your new Navy family. Today's graduates will serve as the bedrock of our American Naval Forces and will join other sailors around the world to defend freedom and liberty against those who threaten. I can say with pride this training group is ready to graduate today. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 470 of the newest, sharpest sailors of the United States Navy.
Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the five mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors individually and as teams met performance standards in one or more mission area events. A division that exceeds basic requirements in these areas during the training qualifies as a battle efficiency division. It is awarded the battle flag in recognition of their performance. Two divisions have earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job well done. Any division that excels in every phase of training and earns all flags qualifies for the Chief of Naval Operations Honor Division recognition and is awarded the CNO Honor Flag for exemplary achievement. This designation reflects a high degree of teamwork, morale, and esprit de corps, as well as the superb leadership of the division commanders. Division 046 has earned this honor today.
Done.
drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Froberg. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Seaman Gustav Gonzalez Campoy, Division 050, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, has earned an Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the 4th Airborne Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Seaman Gonzalez Campoy receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. For having displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Airman Apprentice Alyssa Wilcox, Division 047, from Phoenix, Arizona, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Airman Apprentice Wilcox is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Seaman Devin Bermudez, Division 050, from Moreno Valley, California, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Bermudez is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Seaman Spencer Haley, Division 046, from Melbourne, Australia, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Seaman Haley is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Apprentice Cruz, the staff of Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor. It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Amongst his operational tours as a commissioned officer, he served aboard USS Kitty Hawk, USS Theodore Roosevelt, weapons officer on board USS Nassau, ordnance handling officer on board USS Harry S. Truman, weapons officer on board USS George Washington, and USS Ronald Reagan. Additionally, during his shore tours, he has served as a weapons officer at Naval Air Station Brunswick, Maine, force weapons officer and force ordnance handling officer, commander Naval Air Force's U.S. Pacific Fleet. And in 2017, he returned to the staff of Commander Naval Air Force's U.S. Pacific Fleet, where he currently serves as a Force Weapons Officer. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm recruit training command, Captain Matt Arnold.
Good morning. I'm Captain Matt Arnold, and I am the Senior Limited Duty Officer in the United States Navy, the Silver Eagle, which makes me old. I would like to offer my personal welcome to all of our distinguished guests, the family and friends of our new sailors, and most important, the sailors standing in ranks before us today. It is my great honor and privilege to join you today to welcome these young men and women as the newest sailors into the world's finest Navy. I thank each and every one of you who played an important role in preparing them for their success. You helped shape your recruits into a person who possesses a desire to be of service to their country, who understands the Navy core values of honor, courage, and commitment, and have the drive necessary to accomplish the task set before them. We now also welcome you into the Navy family. To all the sailors standing before me, congratulations on your accomplishments. You look magnificent. In July, of 1987, 36 years ago, I first put on the cloth of our nation, my Navy uniform. Like you, I made the choice to enter the profession of arms and be of service to our great nation. Each of you has selflessly answered the call to duty, to serve a cause greater than yourself. You have passed every test, triumphed over every challenge, and proven yourselves worthy of wearing the uniform that symbolizes freedom throughout the world, the uniform of the United States Navy. Whether you stay for 5 years or 30 years, you have joined an exclusive fraternity of those who have chosen the path of service. Sailors, I can tell you from experience, you are about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. However, I can also tell you that if you serve with honor, keep faith with your fellow shipmates, and strive for excellence in everything you do, it will also be one of the most rewarding experiences of your life. You have chosen to serve your country at a time when your service is most needed, when America must show a strong presence throughout the world, on the seas and in the skies. You have taken on a task of defending our nation. The instructors and staff here at RTC have done a masterful job in preparing you for that tremendous duty and responsibility. You have earned not only my respect, but the respect of a grateful nation. In closing, not as a Navy captain, but as a fellow American, I would like to be the first to say to you, thank you for your service. Congratulations, sailors.
Captain Arnold will now receive the salute of the graduating divisions, and he will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Froberg. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty.
Thank you.
Please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Post. Section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Today is the only day for access to the Navy Exchange and photo pickup. You can pick up your sailor at the Yorktown parking garage today and tomorrow. Sailors going on Liberty without a vehicle are to exit Gate 8 toward the train station parking lot. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. And without further delay, now hear this! Liberty!